Scientific evidence suggests dinosaurs met their extinction through asteroid impact. Today, if a species goes extinct, chances are we as humans had something to do with it. In this century alone, we've lost animals by sea, like the smooth-hand fish, and by land, like the northern white rhinoceros. And yes, by air, even birds, like the ivory-billed woodpecker, to extinction.
Birds are really important because they're indicators of environmental health. Basically, what's good for birds is good for humans.
Jesse Berry, Program Manager, Cornell Lab of Ornithology.
Birds are really the canaries in the coal mine in a lot of ways. They're helping us understand the health of the planet. Right now, all the indicators are pointing to bird populations are declining. And so that's a really critical warning sign for us right now.
But hope is not lost. Berry and her team at Cornell have given all of humankind a chance at redemption. And it's sitting in the palm of our hands, quite literally. Enter the Merlin Bird ID app.
The idea for this app came from just wanting to help people answer the simple question, what's that bird I'm seeing? Because, you know, you might be outside or you look in the backyard and you're like, hey, what is that? And we wanted Merlin to be able to give, you know, a list of possibilities without having to go back to a field guide where maybe, you know, if you don't even have a bird book, and if you do have a bird book, there's all these choices and you might not even know where to start. So Merlin was all about helping you figure out what's that bird I'm seeing in a quick and simple way.
The app allows users to identify birds by a picture, identify birds by songs and calls, and can create a digital scrapbook of the birds you discover.
I found the technology to be really useful.
Denver amateur birdie, Vicky Miles.
Again, I was really a novice birder when it came to anything outside of my backyard. And being able to narrow down, you know, if you see a small bird with some yellow on it, you can narrow it down to five or six possibilities and not have to know whether to look for a warbler or look for a vireo or look for a goldfinch. Merlin just puts them right in front of you.
Alabama wildlife photographer Lisa Moat Smith is also an avid user.
Being a wildlife photographer, it's very nice to be able to look up a particular bird so that I can identify that bird on my website when I post my photographs. I absolutely fell in love with it.
And more good news, it's educating scientists on how climate change is affecting the migratory patterns of birds.
The question is really, will species of birds be able to adapt to these changing ecosystems? And you know, some are more adaptable than others, so we're certainly watching very carefully to see how bird populations are doing and trying to understand how climate change is affecting species across their ranges.